As I said, the ABC this week has once again shown anti-Israel bias by disinviting a Jewish music artist from one of its radio programs. Apparently, her pro-Israel views made her too controversial. But that's just one of many cancellations that Deborah Conway has faced since the war in Israel began. Deborah joins us now. Deborah, great to see you again. Thanks for coming on Outsiders this morning. Tell us about your cancelling. Tell us about your cancelling, how it came about and why you decided you were not going to sit silent.
So I wrote a book last year, and off the back of that book, we constructed a theatre show, and we've been performing that theatre show around the country, and we're just about to do some more regional shows in Melbourne, and the promoter of a couple of these shows organised a publicist to get some publicity, and he booked an interview with the ABC, David Astell's evening programme. And that was scheduled for a few days later. And on the morning of the said interview, I was contacted by the publicist and told that the producer had just arrived back from overseas and had suddenly caught up with the controversy that I was surrounded by and decided I was too hot, too controversial to have on their light evening entertainment show. So I was summarily dismissed. And I'm like, wait a minute, I'm not there to talk about the Middle East. I have no interest in talking about politics. I just want people to come to my show, which is pretty good. But they were not to be dissuaded. So I thought about it for a while. I contacted someone that I thought might have some sway. He gave it a go. There was no shifting within the ABC at that point. So I decided I just can't take this lying down. It wasn't about me at that point. It was about the idea that a taxpayer-funded institution that we all look to in some way to present us all Australians within their airwaves and TV shows or whatever. I know that can be, you know, maybe hopeful, but I remain optimistic a little bit. It was not to be. So I decided we should go to the press, and I contacted Cameron Stewart from the Australian newspaper, who I'd had something to do with before, and he wrote an article about it.
Rita?
Well, you've spoken out, and you've possibly have the profile and the history as an artist to deal with this cancellation, because this is not an isolated event. But how is the climate of self-censorship, intimidation in the artistic community? How many others are remaining silent because they're too scared to lose bookings, to lose interviews?
Well, from my observation, I think there's probably many more people that have something to say about it, but in fact are intimidated because of the pylons that they see other people getting. I mean, there's been just this outrageous hate that's been circulating online, but it also breaks out into the real world. If you think it just stays online, it doesn't. People's shops have been graffitied. Anna Schwartz's art gallery's been graffitied. People are abused in the street. Mezuzahs have been torn off doors. There's been, you know, people have gone down to Caulfield to protest about a fire in a burger joint that was, you know, it was not the fault of any Jews. There's been a lot of real world examples. I know someone who was arrested trying to get into a vote at council at the Melbourne Town Hall, but who were, you know, trying to beat him up, they were left alone. So there's not just intimidation online and by words and by threats to either remove you from a performing program. There's also some kind of physical kind of threat as well. So it's the whole thing is a really murky soup of ugliness. And if you don't have to step into it, then you probably prefer to stay away.
But James,
I found it too upsetting to stay silent. So that's why I had to speak up.
And, I mean, this is, you know, you mentioned a bunch of examples. We've also seen that at the University of Sydney now there have been reports that, you know, you do not want to show your Jewishness or you will feel under physical threat things of this nature. But are you concerned now that there's a movement in society, particularly among sort of the cultural gatekeepers, that support for Israel is now suddenly, you know, an idea that is now akin to being racist or being an apartheid supporter, that it is now something that is, to borrow a phrase, unfortunately, beyond the pale, and that this is really tilting in very, you know, anti-Semitic and not just anti-Zionist or, you know, well, we're not fans of what Israel is doing sort of direction?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that the word Zionist has been completely co-opted to mean something that it actually doesn't mean. It's simply the declaration of a desire for Jewish people to have self-determination within their own state. It's now being equated with Nazism, with apartheid, with white supremacy, with colonialist, with oppressor. There's all kinds of layers that are going on top of this. And it's as much as I can see, it's propaganda, and it's being bought whole by a certain cohort of people who do have enormous influence in our thinking organs, you know, our media, our education, our schools, you know,
absolutely.
Politics.